I want to give you a second to have a seat, to find your spine, find your breath, and really listen to this word and how your body reacts to it when it hears it. Discipline. I know for me, having a martial arts background, when I hear the word discipline, I think, okay, every day at this time, make sure that it's done right on time and nothing can be late, and it's very, And so when I'm working on compassionate discipline, a really helpful thing is this idea of dissolve. So whether you're someone who leans toward discipline, or someone who leans toward maybe a little too much compassion and, oh, I'll do it tomorrow. No, maybe the next day. We're looking for that middle ground. And this is the week of Shiva. And for those of you that don't know, Shiva, right here, little Nataraj, I like to call him the great dissolver. Sometimes he's called the great destroyer, but I like the word dissolve. Because if we have this idea of my discipline is like this, or my discipline is like this, I don't know, there's still very solid ideas that we have of our own discipline. So perhaps a way to find compassionate discipline would be for us to dissolve both ideas that we have of discipline, or any idea that we have of discipline. So whatever that little talk has brought up for you, I want you to notice how that feels in your body, and I want you to inhale it all in. And as you exhale, I want you to say to yourself, dissolve. And then inhale in whatever this next thing is. It doesn't really matter. Just inhale it in. And then as you exhale, again, just say to yourself, dissolve. Now you can add a noun to the end of that if you want, like dissolve me, dissolve fear, dissolve this, whatever. And then just inhale in this next thing. And then exhale, dissolve. If you're a chanter, you can Om Namah Shivaya it if you would like. If you would like to just keep this idea of dissolve going, let's take a deep inhale in, get the spine a little bit longer. And close the eyes, exhale it out, dissolve. Take a deep inhale in, let the belly fill up, the diaphragm fill up. Exhale out and dissolve, press the belly back toward the spine. Take a deep, deep, deep inhale in whatever's coming in. And exhale out and dissolve. Inhale, reach the arms out and up. And the palms together, exhale them down in between the eyes. May your practice cultivate enlightened thoughts. Inhale, exhale the hands in front of the mouth. May your practice cultivate enlightened speech. Inhale, exhale the hands in front of your heart. May all of your practices cultivate an enlightened heart. We're just going to come into downward facing dog. Notice your inhales and exhales. Spread the fingers, press through the palms, bend one knee and then the other. Getting into your body, allowing whatever is happening in your body to come to the surface on the inhale, and then dissolve on the exhale. I promise if it's that important, you will remember it later. Whatever comes up, just keep dissolving, breathing. And we're going to inhale forward to plank. Exhale slowly down to the earth. Untuck the toes. We're going to inhale up for cobra. Roll the shoulders back. Press down with the tops of the feet. Try and tuck the chin. And then exhale and release. Inhale, lift up. Why not use the strength of your hands, use the strength of your low back, and exhale. Inhale. And exhale. And tuck your toes, inhale up for plank. Exhale, downward facing dog. And let's inhale forward to plank. Exhale, floating all the way down. Untuck the toes, inhale up. Exhale, release, tuck your toes, inhale up for plank. Exhale, downward facing dog. Walk the hands back to the feet. Little bend in the knees, clasp opposite elbows. Rock from side to side. Really start to wake up the legs, the hamstrings. Deep breaths with every exhale, dissolving whatever is coming up. Hands to your shins or the floor, inhale halfway up. Exhale, dissolve the whole spine, but try and press back through the legs. So inhale up, long through the spine. Pull the feet toward each other, engage your adductors, and exhale. Release, feel your whole torso long, spine long. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, pull it in. Exhale, dissolve it out. A few more. And then releasing down, deep bend in the knees, drop the hands, and then slowly roll up one vertebra at a time. Coming up to standing, and we're going to bend down into our knees, reach the fingers up for chair pose, inhale in, exhale, releasing down, straightening the legs, the hands come up and over the back, and inhale, chair, exhale, fold, move at the pace of your own breath. Let each inhale be an opportunity to pull in whatever thoughts, whatever sensations, whatever feelings are coming up, and exhale, dissolve. You can even say to yourself, dissolve, dissolve. Notice if you're reaching fully through your fingertips. Feeling long through the whole spine. Close your eyes if you can. Dissolve, dissolve. On your next inhale, hold the breath, stay in the chair. Engage Mula Bandha. Hands together, exhale, down to the heart. Stay in the chair. Deep inhale. Exhale, sit a little deeper. Deep inhale. Exhale, sit a little deeper. Inhaling whatever is going on. Exhale, dissolve into a forward fold. A few nice deep breaths. little bend in the knee, slowly roll up one vertebra at a time. We're going to come out into a horse stance, or goddess. Knees out over the toes, pull the heels in toward each other. Try to not tuck too far back in the pelvis. Let's keep the spine aligned. And we're going to reach the arms out to the side. Deep breaths. Now, if you'd like a little bit more of the discipline from martial arts, bring the hands in, and we're going to inhale and take the arm across from shoulder to shoulder, elbow to elbow. It's a nice, easy block. We're going to exhale each time. Like to keep your arms out to the side, you can just join with a breath of fire. Just a few more seconds wherever you are. Take a deep inhale in. And exhale. Pasarita Padottanasana. Nice wide-legged forward fold. Interlace the hands behind the back if you'd like. And then gently come to seated. Very well-deserved seat after all of that legwork. If you're ever feeling really ungrounded, legwork is a great way to bring you back. So let's sit for a moment. Spine nice and long, close the eyes, palms up or down. We're going to release the jaw, but keep your tongue attached to the back of your top teeth. You can choose to continue with the eyes closed or find a spot about 6 feet in front of you. And then you want to think about your back being long, strong, and solid. And your front, as you breathe, completely loose and fluid and flexible. And you, your breath, is somewhere in the middle of those. I want you to bring your focus down to the base of your spine, down into your legs. See if you can feel the tingle of all of that energy we just cultivated. Now I want to start to move this up the spine. I want to start to move this space, the activity, the blood flow, farther up the spine. I'm going to do that with just a little twist. So let's take the right leg over the left. I'm doing the same as you, not opposite. Left elbow on that right knee. If you have a little cushion, I have my little Zafu. It is rather comfortable. Spine nice and long. And a little twist if you'd like. You can also grab that knee with your hand. A few deep breaths, long through the spine. And let's take a deep inhale. And exhale and dissolve. Deep inhale in, take in whatever is coming up next. And then dissolve and see if you can twist just a little bit deeper. Deep inhale in. And dissolve. Take one more inhale in, and exhale and unwind, and cross the left over the right, and a nice twist, deep inhale, lengthen, exhale, dissolve, deep breaths at your own pace. One more inhale, and exhale, unwind. All right, let's relax back down. And I want you to notice if there's a little bit of muddiness going on now. A lot of times when we get really earthy and watery like this, one of my teachers used to let me know that one of my pitfalls was that I can turn into a swamp. When you mix all that earth and mud together with water, sometimes our energy gets a little stagnant, right? This can also be the tamasic kind of energy. But it's still energy, so let's continue moving it up the spine. First, just visualize that. Just visualize what's down the base of your spine moving its way up your body as you inhale. And then exhale, let it dissolve. So now we want to bring in a little bit of fire. And this is connected to our solar plexus, our third chakra, our confidence, our diaphragm, our breath, our prana. So we're going to get into our prana. We're going to come into breath of fire. Fingers, you can touch Gyan Mudra if you'd like. Spine nice and long, pump the belly, and on each exhale, focus on the idea of dissolve. Deep inhale in. Hold the breath at the top. Engage Mulaban, tuck the chin. Whatever has come up, dissolve it on the exhale. Hands come up to the shoulders. Fingers in the front, thumb in the back. Inhale to the left. Exhale to the right. Close the eyes. Take an inhale in, reach the elbows up, try and touch the back of your hands. Engage Mulaban. And open the mouth, exhale it out. Now see if you can notice where the tingle is, the energy, the blood flow, the focus, your thoughts. Inhale it in. Exhale, dissolve them out. Inhale in. Om Namah Shivaya, if you'd like. Inhale in. Om Namah Shivaya. Inhale in. Om Namah Shivaya. Inhale in. Om Namah Shivaya. Just keep saying, dissolve Shiva to yourself. Now we're going to interlace the fingers. Place them behind the neck. Support right at that occipital joint so that we can take an inhale and open the heart. And exhale and bow. Inhale, open the heart. Exhale and bow. Moving at the pace of your own breath. The inhale is more important than opening the heart is more important than how far we come forward. And again, continuing with every exhale as dissolve or Om Namah Shivaya. Take an inhale in, open the heart, engage Mulaban, and exhale, dissolve, relax. Notice where you are, notice your thoughts, notice the sensations, the feeling around you. Inhale it in. And let it dissolve as you exhale. Let's roll back down onto our backs. Pull our knees into our chest. Wrap our knees. Grab opposite elbows if you can, or just hold on. Send the feet up over the head if you would like, and come into plow. Letting all that energy that we started with our legs roll all the way through the spine up toward the crown of the head. Same deep breaths. Same dissolve. Notice where the mind goes. Notice where the thoughts go. Just continue to dissolve. Notice any distractions, frustrations, judgments, boredom, desires, hopes, needs, fears. Just watch them as they come up and dissolve them with each exhale. Not getting rid of them, just dissolving them. As you're ready, slowly make our way down. Place the heels down, knees bent. We have the fingers up, our palms pressing onto the earth. We're going to inhale into bridge. Exhale down one vertebra at a time. Be here for a little while. Dissolving with each exhale, whatever comes up. And when you feel like you are ready, when you feel that you have dissolved each little spot of your spine, any spots of resistance, solidity left in your spine, if it's all been worked out, or at least as much as it'll be worked out for now, you can find your way into a nice shavasana. Letting the toes fall apart, palms face up, tucking one shoulder blade and then the other. Spine really long. And now notice your mindscape. Notice your thoughts and feelings. Inhale them in, and exhale and dissolve. Inhaling in whatever comes next. And exhale and dissolve. Inhaling in. Exhale, dissolve. Dissolve. Find an inhale, dissolve on the exhale. As you inhale and exhale, start to find your way back into your body, rolling onto one side or the other, and find your way to a comfortable seated position. Taking your time, allowing that sense of dissolve to continue even as you move forward. Notice if your breath is a little different, your thoughts are a little different. Your heart maybe feels a little bit different. And notice if the word discipline perhaps doesn't have quite so much attached to it anymore. Inhale, reach the arms out and up. Bring the palms together, exhale them down in between the arms. May your life be filled with enlightened thoughts. Inhale, exhale the hands in front of the mouth. May you always have the patience for enlightened speech. Inhale, exhale the hands in front of the heart. May your heart have the healing it requires to live an enlightened life. Namaste. Thank you for making it possible for me to have explorations like this. My whole day has been very mindful, lots of meditating and chanting, and I put aside this day for this class. So thank you for allowing me to guide, and thank you for teaching me. This was really inspired by a student who just commented that at the end of one of my classes, she felt like she had melted into a puddle. And I was like, yeah, dissolving is a really powerful practice. So I wanted to make this practice specifically inspired to dissolve us. Shiva is one of my favorite chants and favorite ideas, so I'm glad to be able to share it with you. Thank you. And these are all donation-based classes, so if you'd like to donate, there's a link on your screen. You can also join these awesome people who have all decided to donate on a regular basis at patreon.com/freeyoga. And we're all getting to know each other now, which is really fun. And thank you all for this community. I have learned so much. I have such gratitude for all of you. So please keep asking questions and keeping me on my toes, because I really appreciate it. I would not be able to keep moving forward if it wasn't for all the wonderful questions and people that exist in this world. So thank you. Namaste.